Okay, in today's webinar, I'd like to focus on three aspects of painting snow: the color of the snow, effects of the aerial perspective, and the effects of plane changes to the values and the colors. With regard to the snow color, two things to keep in mind, and that is to avoid using straight white for our snow. On the shadow side, it generally reflects the sky and the colors in the sky and surrounding subject matter. And on the light side, of course, it takes on the color of the light source. So one thing to keep in mind is to always put some type of color. Even on an overcast day, the grays from the sky will come down and begin to affect the color of the snow. The second thing about snow that's a little different than other subject matter is it has to do with the effects of the aerial perspective. So that as the snow recedes, it warms and often darkens as it goes back in space. So two things to think about today and keep an eye on as we do the demo. And then lastly, how planes affect values and colors. So within the shadow and within the light, there will usually always be a value and color change that corresponds with any type of angle change to the ground plane or the subject that the snow is falling on. So from the ground plane to the mountain, there's a major shift in a plane. But even within those areas, even within the ground plane, there could be variations to the ground underneath the snow that causes the snow to angle maybe more towards the horizon of the sky versus towards the zenith, that sort of thing that we want to take into account as we proceed with the demo today. I'll touch on those subjects.
In how we treat our edges and in representing the subject matter, it's not just a matter of putting down daubs of white. Some of these daubs of white I'm using to cut in between the trees, and I'm leaving little trunks of trees shooting up between those lighter areas of snow. So I'm actually thinking about what I'm doing when I'm putting down these marks and how, what they represent and how to represent them. Virtually impossible to paint everything that's out there. So I just want to create symbols. You know, you can see how, you know, little vertical strokes that I lift off indicate, you know, perhaps a pine tree in the distance or in the middle ground. So a delicate touch and being cognizant of what the paint is doing and how it's representing the subject matter, always vitally important to our paintings.